Please mute your audio. 84. Right. Okay, we are discussing about the module 3, which is performance of transmission lines. So under this, we were completed a few numerical problems in the previous class, so which are regarding short, medium and long transmission lines. So now let us discuss Ferranti effect and effect of this Ferranti effect on voltage regulation of the line, wavelength, velocity of propagation of waves, surge impedance and surge impedance of long lines. Right. So we are going to discuss about these three topics today. Okay. Right. Upon completion of this topic, you can explain the Ferranti. What is Ferranti effect and how Ferranti effect will affect the voltage regulation, and you can also define the wavelength and velocity of propagation of the wave, and what is surge impedance and what is the surge impedance loading of the transmission lines. Okay, right. Let us first see the Ferranti effect. What is Ferranti effect? And so under no load conditions or light load conditions, so the receiving end voltage of the transmission line is greater than the sending end voltage. So this effect of the line is called the Ferranti effect. So generally, if you observe a transmission line, if you take a transmission line, you will be having sending end voltage this side and receiving end voltage at the load. Right here, this is a transmission line which is having a series impedance and series impedance, which is consisting of resistance as well as reactance. Right. Usually, this VR will be less than the VS. Right. Under full load condition, if you observe, if you draw the equivalent circuit for this transmission line network, right, then the receiving end voltage is generally less than the sending end voltage. So, but in some cases, so the receiving end voltage will be greater than the sending end voltage. So that effect is called the Ferranti effect. Okay. So this Ferranti effect you can observe only on no load and light load conditions. Okay. So the Ferranti effect can be defined as, under no load or light load conditions, the receiving end voltage of the transmission line is greater than the sending end voltage. So this effect of the transmission line is called the Ferranti effect. Okay. Now this Ferranti effect will be mainly observed in long transmission lines and very rarely in medium transmission lines. Okay. So in long transmission lines, the Ferranti effect will be observed. Okay, why this Ferranti effect will be Ferranti effect, that is receiving end voltage is greater than sending end voltage, why this happens? So this happens because of the shunt capacitance of the transmission lines. So when you consider the long transmission line, there is a more shunt capacitance, right? That shunt capacitance will draw the current, that current is called the charging current. Okay, so when you apply the alternating voltage, the current will flows through the capacitors. So the current flowing through that capacitors is called the charging current. Okay. So that charging current, you can also say that it is a capacitive current. Why? Because it is flowing through the capacitor. Okay. So now when the voltage is applied at the sending end, the current drawn by the capacitance of the line is more when compared to the load. Okay. So now if you are having a transmission line, it is connected to the load here. So you are having the impedance and shunt capacitance. Okay, the current flowing through this capacitance, you can call it as a charging current or capacitive current. Okay, so under light load conditions, if it is a long transmission line, right, you are sending, you are applying a voltage of Vs to your long transmission line, right? So then if there is no load at the transmission line or there is a light load, so in such case, current flowing through the capacitance will be very high when compared to the load. Suppose if there is a light load, so now the current flowing through this load will be very less when compared to the current flowing through this capacitance. Okay. So because of that reason, the no load, the voltage at the receiving end will be greater than the sending end voltage. Okay. So this effect is called the Ferranti effect. Right. What is Ferranti effect? So Ferranti effect is the effect which makes the receiving end voltage greater than the sending end voltage. So why this Ferranti effect will happen? Due to the charging current, okay, due to the charging current which is flowing through the capacitance. So where this Ferranti effect will be observed? So this Ferranti effect will be observed mostly in long transmission lines. Okay, you can even observe a little bit in medium transmission line also. Okay, so but mostly the Ferranti effect will be observed in long lines only. Right. So let us explain the Ferranti effect from our rigorous solution. Rigorous solution is also called as exact solution. Okay. So now for long transmission lines, from the exact solution, you can say that Vs is equal to cos h gamma l into Vr plus Zc into sin h gamma l into Ir. Right. From the exact solution. So exact solution consisting of Vs and Is. So they were represented in a matrix form. You will be having cos h l, cos h gamma l, then Zc into sin h gamma l. One by Zc into sin h gamma l. Again here you are having cos h gamma l. Vr ir. Okay, this is the matrix form representation of your exact solution of transmission line. Okay, from this Vs can be written as cos h gamma l into Vr plus Zc into sin h gamma l into Ir. So this is the sending end voltage. Now under no load condition. Under no load condition, if you observe, the current flowing through the receiving end will be zero. If there is no load on the transmission line, IR will become equal to zero. So now if you substitute IR equal to zero, this second part will become equal to zero. So then sending end voltage is equal to VR into cos h gamma l. Okay, from this VR, receiving end voltage can be written as VR is equal to Vs by cos h gamma l. Okay, so this is the receiving end voltage when there is a no load on the transmission line. Now if you see here, in the denominator you have the term cos h gamma l, right? So this cos h gamma l, if you calculate, that cos h gamma l value will be in between 0 to 1. Okay? So that means it is cos always less than or equal to 1. Okay, so that means if the numerator is less than 1, so what will be the total value if you compare VR and VS? So VR will be greater than Vs. Okay, so from this equation you can say that VR is greater than Vs. Okay, so like this, this is the explanation from the rigorous solution. Okay, so now you can even represent this with a phasor diagram by taking the exact solution itself. Okay, so now from this equation. Hello, you are mute your audio, ma. Right, you can write up to this only. So, but if you want to extend this explanation from the rigorous solution, you can also explain by drawing a vector diagram. All right. So, from this equation, you can write that Vs is equal to Vr into this cos h gamma l can be written as e power gamma l plus e power minus gamma l by 2. Again, here is gamma is a complex number which is in the form of alpha plus j beta. Now, if you substitute this alpha plus j beta in place of gamma in this equation, so then this Vs value you will get is Vs is equal to Vr by this 2, Vr by 2 into, so this e power gamma l can be written as e power alpha l plus j beta l. So that can be written as e power alpha l into e power beta l. Plus, for this, if you substitute in this equation alpha plus j beta in place of gamma, then this term can be written as Vr by 2 e power minus alpha by alpha l and e power minus j beta l. Here you will get j. Okay, here also you will get j here. Okay, you are having alpha plus j beta. So this e power gamma l can be written as e power alpha plus j beta into L. So thus L will come here and here. So now e power a plus b can be written as e power a into e power b. Okay, so e power alpha L into e power j beta L equal to. So for this, here we are having the minus e power minus L. This we will get here minus, so this can be written as e power minus alpha L into e power minus j beta L. Okay. Right. This is the solution. What is we derived in the previous slide. So now, if it is magnitude, let us see. So let us, this is a like a magnitude. So now this value. So if you observe here, you are having e power alpha L here. You are having e power minus alpha L here, right? This Vs term will be having two terms. This is one term. This is another term. Okay. So if you see this term, it is exponentially increasing, and if you see this term, it is exponentially decreasing the magnitude. Okay. Here you are having e power minus alpha L. Here you are having e power alpha L. E power alpha L means as length of L, length L is increasing, this magnitude will be exponentially will increase, and this magnitude will exponentially will decrease. Right? If you observe the direction will be represented by this number, this complex number. Okay. So e power j beta L. So this can be written as one at an angle beta L. Okay. So in the similar manner, e power minus j beta L. This can be written as one at an angle minus beta L. Okay. So now if you take VR as a reference here. So this is your VR reference value. Okay. So now, if you see this angle is plus, and this angle is minus. That means, as the length is increasing, so this angle will go in anti-clockwise direction. That means, if positive angles will be represented in the above side of your reference, negative angles this side. That means, as length of the transmission line is going on increasing, you will get this vector. Will be in this side. Beta L will be increasing in this way, and minus beta will be in this way. So you can say that this term will exponentially will increase, and a direction will be in anti-clockwise direction. Okay, and for the second term, the magnitude will be exponentially decreasing, and direction will be in clockwise direction. So now let us this if you call it as EI. So now this term is also called as incident wave. So the and this also term known as reflected wave under no load condition. Let us see incident wave EI under no load condition, ER under no load condition. Okay. So a clear understanding about what is reflected wave, what is incident wave, we will discuss in the next unit. Okay. Let us see in this VS you are having two terms. So one term is exponentially increasing, another term is exponentially decreasing by increasing the length of the transmission line. Right? One term which is exponentially increasing term, that term is called the incident wave. The other term is called the reflected wave. As this voltage is under no load case, so this will be incident wave under no load condition. This is the reflected wave under no load condition. This incident wave under no load condition will be exponentially increasing, and it will rotate in anti-clockwise direction. Okay, so see here this. If you take one point, so this locus is as L increasing, it will be like this. Okay, so this is in this manner. So this side, this is the vector which is ERO, and this is the vector which is EIO. Okay, so this will be in this direction. EIO will be, and this will be in this direction. Okay. And the sum of these two, sum of this OB and OC, so this is this will be equal to your total sending end voltage, which is this one. Okay. Now, if you observe from the vector diagram, this sending end voltage will be less than the receiving end voltage. So that means receiving end voltage is greater than sending end voltage. So this effect is called the Ferranti effect. Okay. This is how you can explain the Ferranti effect from a rigorous solution. If you are not understood this vector diagram, you can stop up to here itself. Okay, so here itself you are getting that from the rigorous solution, your VR value is greater than the VS value. Okay, so next another method. Suppose if the Ferranti effect, if you observe in medium transmission line, then you can use the nominal pi method. So now, before that, let us explain this Ferranti effect by approximate basis. Okay, so we are going to take some assumptions. Now, by that you can explain the Ferranti effect. Okay, so let us see here. You consider a transmission line equivalent circuit. Okay, so your transmission line will be having a series impedance, series inductance, and shunt capacitance. Okay, generally the transmission line parameters will be distributed. But for analysis purpose, let us consider them as a distributed parameters. For analysis purpose, you have to consider them as a lumped parameters. Okay, this is the resistance of the transmission line, inductance of the transmission line, and capacitance is the shunt element, or this one. Okay, so now let us call L is the inductance of the transmission line per unit length. Okay, and C will be the capacitance of transmission line per unit length. Okay, if the length of the transmission line is L, so then total inductance will be capital L into L, and total capacitance will be capital C into L. Okay, so this capital N and capital C, these are the inductance and capacitance values per unit length. Okay, if you want for complete length, you have to multiply this with L. So this will be the L into, so this inductance L into small L, length of the transmission line, and this will be the capacitance C into L. Okay, so you are having the resistance. If smaller is the resistance of the transmission line per unit length, so then total resistance will be smaller into L. Okay, so now for our analysis purpose, so let us consider this resistance will be very small. Generally for a long transmission line, the resistance will be very less, so you can neglect this resistance value. Okay, so you can neglect resistance value, then the equivalent circuit will become like this. You will be having only inductance and capacitance. Inductance value is capital L into small l, and capacitance is small capital C into L, and L and C values are inductance and capacitance per unit length. Okay, now here you are having the sending end voltage, and here you are having the receiving end voltage, and current flowing from the sending end is IS. Okay, so now if you observe under no load condition, that means here you are not connecting any load, so then IR will be equal to zero. Okay, receiving end current is zero. That means, so this is the equivalent circuit of the transmission line. So by considering a resistance as neglected and under no load conditions, okay, so there is no load connected, so IR will be equal to zero. Okay, so if there is no load, means this inductance and this capacitance will come in series. Okay, so now for this exact equivalent circuit, which is approximate equivalent circuit, so you write the sending end current equation. Sending end current IS is equal to VS by total impedance. Okay, so these two are in series, so the reactance of this can be written as J omega L. L here is L into small l, and this capacitance can be written as 1 by J omega C. Okay, so J omega C, actually that C value, total value is C into L. Okay, so the total reactant is sum of these two. Okay, so current IS is equal to VS by J omega L into small l plus 1 by J omega C into L. Okay, so now if you observe for a transmission line, that capacitance C value is very small when compared to the inductance value. So generally this inductance value, if you are calculated, you will get in millihenries, and this capacitance will be in, generally in micros. So that means this capacitance value will be very small when compared to the inductance. Okay, so when capacitance is small, so then what about this total term? So 1 by capacitance you are having, okay, 1 by C. When C is very small, so this total value will be very high when compared to this total value J omega L. Okay, so this J omega L, so this can be neglected here. Okay, SAS capacitance C is very small compared to the L, and capacitance value is in the denominator in this term. So the total term will be very high when compared to this total term. Okay, so this this term we will neglect, and we will be having Vs by 1 by j omega CL. So that can be written as Is will be approximately equal to. So that means you are going to neglect this term. So Is will be approximately equal to the j Vs into omega CL. That means this term will go into denominator. So j omega Vs into omega CL. Okay. So this is the current flowing through the transmission network. Okay. So now you observe the VR. What is VR? Receiving end voltage. So this receiving end voltage is equal to. So this receiving end voltage again is the voltage across this. That means voltage across these two points. So this VR can be equal to this Vs minus drop across this. Okay. So Vs minus drop across this inductance is current flowing through the inductance and this inductance value. So inductance value J omega C, sorry, G omega capital L into small l. Right. So voltage drop is Is into J omega capital L into small l. Okay. This one. So now in place of Is, you can write this equation. Is is equal to J Vs into omega CL. You can write right this product into this product. Okay. So VR can be written as VR, sorry, Vs plus. So plus how we are getting? In place of this, you are going to substitute this. So that means J into J, J square you will get. J square value minus 1. Thus minus and this minus will get plus. Okay. So then you are having Vs and omega into omega, omega square, CL into L into L, L square. Okay. So the total receiving end voltage is sending end voltage plus Vs into omega square CL into L square. Okay. So from this equation, again, VR, if you take Vs as common, VR is equal to Vs into 1 plus omega square CL into L square, you will get. Okay. So now if you see this equation, if you see this equation, or this equation, okay. So your VR voltage is Vs voltage plus this value. So that means there is a voltage rise. The magnitude of voltage rise is equal to this term. She was concerned about you both and she carried your backpacks here. So you should make sure to thank her later, okay? Okay. She's who found us. Okay, ma'am. If you observe this equation, which is the VR value, so VR is equal to Vs plus this value. So that means VR is greater than Vs. Okay. So how much value VR is greater than Vs is this value, right? So magnitude of voltage rise is equal to this total magnitude. So Vs omega square CL into L square. Okay. This is the voltage magnitude rise. Okay. So this is how you explain, how you can explain the Ferrante effect on approximate basis. This V is equal to 1 by square root of L C is called the velocity of propagation of the wave, right? If you write in terms of velocity of the propagation of waves, then voltage rise can be written as magnitude of Vs omega square. In place of CL, you can write as the 1 by V square, right? So that V is the velocity of propagation of the wave. What is velocity of propagation of wave? We will discuss in the upcoming slides. Okay. So, okay, ma'am. So this is the explanation of Ferrante effect on approximate basis. Okay. Approximate basis in the sense we are going to consider some of the terms to be neglected. Okay. First two you have here in the equivalent circuit, you are neglected the resistance, and in the calculations here you are neglecting the inductance term. Okay. You are going to neglect two terms. So because of that, this analysis can be said as approximate analysis. Okay. So from this analysis also, you can say that your receiving end voltage VR is greater than the sending end voltage by a magnitude which is equal to Vs into omega square CL into L square. Okay? Okay. Right. Now you can explain the Ferrante effect from nominal pi method also. So as I said before, even some cases in medium transmission lines also, you can observe the Ferrante effect. Okay, if you see here, if you see the classification of transmission line, so the medium transmission line will be having a length from 80 to let us say 250 kilometers. So in some of the textbook it will be given 160 only. Okay, in some of the textbook it will be 250 kilometers. Okay, so but generally up to 250 kilometers, let us consider it as a medium transmission line only. Suppose a long transmission line will be from 250 to above, or the long transmission line. Right? If you are having a transmission line which is having 245 length, okay, 245 kilometers, then how we can say that this is very near to the long transmission line? Okay, 250 is your long transmission line, so almost it is near to the long transmission line only. Okay, in such a case, even though it may come under median transmission line, you can observe the Ferranti effect. Okay, so but the effect of Ferranti effect will be very less. Okay, so if your median transmission line is 85 kilometers, so this will be near to a sharp transmission line where effect of capacitance will be neglected. Okay, so for 85 kilometers there may not be Ferranti effect in medium transmission line. So but if the medium transmission line is 245 kilometers, which is very near to the long transmission line length, so then in such a case, even though if it is a medium transmission line, you can observe the Ferranti effect. Okay, so for that case, how you can analyze the Ferranti effect, right? So let us take the nominal pi method for medium transmission line.
Amazon lo ledu baba Ferranti effect. Amazon lo ledu.
Okay, let us consider a nominal pi model of the transmission line, so which is under no load condition. That means, so this Ferranti effect will be only observed on no load or light load condition. So you have to consider the no load and you have to analyze the Ferranti effect. Okay, so here, so for to analyze the Ferranti effect, you are not going to consider any load at the terminals, at the receiving end terminals. Okay, so then if you draw the nominal pi model of the line, so this will be like this, right? In nominal pi model, you will be having total capacitance will be divided into two halves, and one will be connected at the sending end, another will be connected at the receiving end. These are the C/2 capacitance. And here you will be having the transmission line impedance Z, which is having total resistance plus inductance. Okay, and current flowing through current from the sending end is IS. So now at this node it will be divided into IC1 and IC2. Okay, so this is actually IL, current flowing through the transmission line. But as there is a no load here, so this IL and IC1, current flowing through this capacitance, will be same. So the IL will be known as the IC1 here. You can represent with IC1 itself. Okay. Now, if you draw the phasor diagram for this network by taking the VR as the reference. Okay. So this is VR, which is your reference, right? So now, current flowing through your capacitance, this IC1. So as this is a pure capacitance, current will always lead the VR. So this will be the IC1 value. Okay. So now, if you want to get the VS, right? So VS is equal to drop across this resistance, drop across this reactance, plus this VR value. So that means this can be written as VR plus IC1 into R plus IC1 into X. Okay, so if you write in magnitude, so this is the magnitude of VR, this is the magnitude of IC1 into R, this is magnitude of IC1 into X. Okay, so if you want to write in vector of polar form, these all those are vectors only. So here you may get J. Right, now to get the value of VS, for this vector VR you have to add IC1 R. Okay, IC1 is R is the voltage drop across the resistance. So the voltage drop across the resistance will be in series with the current IC1. So that means in the current IC1 direction is in this direction, right? So here at the edge of the VR, you are going to add IC1 into R. So which is in the direction of your IC1. Okay. So and if you see the this voltage drop IC1 into X, right? This voltage drop is 90 degrees lag, 90 degrees to your IC1. Okay, So you see here, so this is the voltage drop. Okay, so this voltage will be lagging or leading with IC1. It will be leading. Okay, voltage will be leading the current I by J. This is an angle of 90 degrees. So here you have to represent a vector IC1 into X, which is 90 degrees to your current IC1. Okay, so this is the direction of current. So 90 degrees means in this direction you have to represent. Okay, so and this voltage drop is leading here. So this direction, if it is lagging, this direction you have to represent. Okay, so you know all these in from the network theory. So then now your VS is this one. Okay, so from the vector diagram you can see that the magnitude of this VS will be less than your magnitude of VR. Okay, that means VR magnitude is greater than VS. Okay, from this model, nominal pi model also, if you draw the vector diagram, you can say that magnitude of VR, which is receiving end voltage, is greater than the sending end voltage, which is called the Ferranti effect. Okay. If you want to analyze still in equations form, you see here. So for nominal pi model, you can say that VS is equal to 1 plus YZ by 2 into VR plus Z into AR. Okay. So how you got this from the matrix form representation? Okay, VS VR, for VS IS can be represented in terms of VR and IR, right, with the ABCD parameters. Okay, VS is equal to A into VR plus B into IR. So on A and B for this nominal pi model is, for A it is 1 plus YZ by 2, B value is Z. So VS can be written as VS is equal to 1 plus YZ by 2 into VR plus Z into IR. Okay, so this is the sending end voltage equation from the nominal pi method. Okay, so now to analyze the Ferranti effect will be observed only in no load condition or light load condition. So under no load condition, your IR will be equal to 0. Okay, so that means this term, in this term you are having the IR, so this term will become equal to 0. So then VS is equal to 1 plus YZ by 2 into VR you will get. Okay, so now you take you multiply this with this VR with this one, you will get VR into 1 VR. So YZ into YZ by 2 into VR you will get, right? So this VR you take this side, so then you can write VS minus VR as VS minus VR as YZ by 2 into VR. Okay, so from this equation, VS minus VR you will get YZ by 2 into VR. Okay, so now what is Y and what is Z here? So Y and Z are the total admittance and total impedance of the transmission line network. Okay, so now impedance Z can be written as R plus J omega L. So this is you can also say it in capital L also. Okay, here the small L they were taken, let us take it as this. Okay, so this is this, what is small R and small L here? So small R is the resistance per unit length and small L is the inductance per unit length. Okay, so now if you want to calculate the total impedance, so then these two has to be multiplied with your length of the transmission line, as you have taken a small l as your length or inductance of the transmission line. Here I'm taking s as my total length of the transmission line. Okay, so s is my total length of the transmission line and a small r is your resistance per unit length. So total resistance will be R into S. So L is the inductance per unit length. For entire length S, it will be L into S. So impedance will be R plus RS plus J L into omega into L. Okay. You know that. So Z is equal to R plus JX. Okay. And X here is omega L. Okay, so L is the inductance of the line, total inductance. Capital R is the total resistance. As we observed, small r is the resistance and total resistance per unit length, and total length is S. So capital R is equal to small r into S you will get. In a similar manner, you are assumed that small l is the inductance of the transmission line per unit length. For total length, it will be l into s. Okay, this is total length. Now, in place of r and capital R and l, you are going to substitute small r s, small l into s. Okay, so then impedance can be written as z is equal to r s plus j. Now here x is equal to omega l. So this omega in place of l, you have to write this small l into s. So this is the total impedance of the transmission line. If you take s as common, you will get this value, r plus j omega l into s. Okay. So then what about the admittance y? So admittance y is the reciprocal of your impedance, right? So cent element you are having here is the capacitance. So which is a, this value is a pure capacitance value, okay? So this can be written as 1/xc, okay? So 1/xc. So now this can be written as 1/, so xc is the 1/j omega c, okay? 1/j omega c. So which is equal to j omega c, capital C here. So this is the admittance value. Right, this capital C is the total capacitance of the transmission line. Now, if the transmission line is having small c per unit length of capacitance, then if it is multiplied with the capital total length of the line, you will get the capital C. Okay, so
in normal,
y can be written as j omega small c. Small c here.
Yeah.
The small c is the capacitance per unit length. Yeah. This yes. Okay, I think it is clear here.
100 पे आया पाया ना
राइट. ओके, सो यू सी हियर एस इज द टोटल लेंथ ऑफ द ट्रांसमिशन लाइन. ओके, सो नाउ इफ द रेसिस्टेंस ऑफ द ट्रांसमिशन लाइन इज नेग्लेक्टेड, दिस रेसिस्टेंस इज नेग्लेक्टेड, सो देन जेड विल बिकम इक्वल टू जे ओमेगा एल इनटू एस. ओके, नाउ this z and this y value you substitute in this equation. So then vs minus vr can be written as 1/2 into, in place of y, j omega small c into s, in place of z, j omega small l into s, you will get into this vr. Okay, this can be written as vs minus vr is equal to, so now this j into j, j into j, j square value is -1, so you will get -1/2. So omega into omega, omega square, s into s, s square, lc into vr will get. Okay, vs minus vr, you are getting this equation. Okay, so now you hear again, for overhead transmission line, as I said, 1/√lc is the velocity of the propagation of waves, and this velocity of propagation of waves will be approximately equal to velocity of the light, which is 3×10⁸ meters per second. Okay, that means 1/√lc is 3×10⁸ meters per second, right? Then root lc will be 1/3×10⁸, so lc will be 1/3×10⁸ whole power square, right? In place of lc here, we are going to write 1/3×10⁸ whole square. Okay, so here omega is the 2πf, right? So now if you have substitute 2πf in place of omega, then vs minus vr is equal to minus of 4π² into 10⁻⁶/80 f² s² into vr. Here s is the total length of the transmission line, f is the frequency of the transmission line. Okay, so now this vs minus vr, so this vs minus vr, if you observe, so this value is negative, this value is negative, so which means that you are sending in sending end voltage is less than the receiving end voltage. Okay, from this analysis also you are getting that the vs value is less than vr value, or you can say the receiving end voltage is greater than the sending end voltage. Okay, now and also you can say that from this equation your Ferranti effect depends upon your frequency as well as the length of the transmission line. Okay, Ferranti effect is directly proportional to length of the square of the length of the transmission line as well as square of the frequency. Okay, you remember these two points. They may be asked in your competitive exams. Okay, Ferranti effect depends upon length of the transmission line, which is square of the length of the transmission line, as well as if you see the frequency, this Ferranti effect depends upon the square of the frequency. Okay. Right. Now, how this Ferranti effect will affect the voltage regulation of the transmission line? Okay, effect on voltage regulation. Okay, if you see the percentage voltage regulation of a transmission line, you can write it as a change in voltage from no load to full load, which is expressed as a fraction of full load. Right. So that means VRNL minus VRFL by VRFL. So if you want to percentage, then you have to multiply this value with 100. Okay. So now Ferranti effect will be generally observed in no load condition. Okay. Under no load condition, what is the VR value? Okay. So under no load condition, your IR value will be equal to zero. So now this V receiving end voltage is, you can call it as a VR under no load condition. Okay. Right. You can write this VR under no load condition will be equal to VS by A. So as I said before, this your VS is equal to A into VR plus B into IR. So under no load condition, this IR is zero. So this total term is zero. So this VR value under no load condition, which is VRNL, is equal to VS by A. Okay. And VR under full load condition, you can say that that is magnitude of VR. Okay. Now if you substitute these two in this equation, so VRNL is equal to VS by A, VRFL is equal to VR. So then, so percentage of voltage regulation can be written as VS in magnitude of VS minus magnitude of A into magnitude of VR by magnitude of A into VR, you will get. Okay. So now if you see from this equation, so here we are having VS minus magnitude of A into magnitude of VR. Okay. So now if you observe the Ferranti effect, so if there is a Ferranti effect in the transmission line, this magnitude of VR will be greater than the magnitude of your VS. Okay. So that means this VS value will be small when compared to this VR value. Okay. In such a case, what will be this value? This total difference VS minus A into VR value, this value will be negative value. Okay. If there is a Ferranti effect, if you observe, so then this difference, voltage difference, will be negative. So which says that when there is a Ferranti effect, so the voltage regulation of the transmission line becomes negative. Okay. And the power factor will be leading. Why? Because there is a capacitance domination will be there when there is a Ferranti effect. That means which is under no load condition. So if you observe the power factor under Ferranti effect, that power factor will be leading power factor. Okay. Regulation will be negative and power factor will be leading. Okay. So this is about the Ferranti effect. Okay. How you can reduce this Ferranti effect? Okay. So Ferranti effect is mainly due to the capacitance. Okay. Shunt capacitance. Okay. The domination of shunt capacitance, which is under no load conditions. Okay. So now how you can reduce this Ferranti effect? So that means you have to get a VR value as near to the sending end voltage. It should not be greater than the sending end voltage. Okay. So now if there is a, see here, according to Ferranti, if there is a Ferranti effect, your VR value will be very higher than the VS value. Okay. So generally you hear in at the receiving end, you will connect your appliances or your load will be connected at the receiving end, right? If your receiving end voltage is greater than the sending end voltage, and this load in the sense it may be fan, it may be light, it may be your refrigerator, right? So some electrical appliances, right? If you observe the electrical appliances ratings, so those electrical appliances will be rated for some specific voltage. Okay, so if the voltage is greater than that specified voltage of the appliances, so then your equipment will damage. Okay, your voltage will be within limits, right? So it must be equal to your specified value or there may be some tolerance will be given. So, but if it is more than the tolerance limit, so then what may happen? Your equipment will damage. Okay, due to Ferranti effect, receiving end voltage will be greater than the sending end voltage. So, as the receiving end voltage is more than the more, so then the appliances may damage. Okay, so now you have to reduce this Ferranti effect. That means you have to reduce your receiving end voltage. Okay, so this receiving end voltage is greater due to the capacitance, sent capacitance. Okay, so now if you want to have the receiving end voltage will be very near to the sending end voltage, so then you have to connect shunt reactors to compensate this capacitance values. Okay, so by connecting the shunt reactor, you can change the VR value to a very near value of your PS. Okay, so that means you can reduce the receiving end voltage by connecting your shunt reactor. So that means you are going to minimize the effect of Ferranti effect by connecting your shunt reactors under no load conditions. Okay. Okay. So this shunt reactor will compensate the capacitive effect so that there will be minimum Ferranti effect. Okay. Or it will be nullify the Ferranti effect also. Okay. So this is how you can minimize the Ferranti effect. Okay. Right. See here, we are explaining the Ferranti effect, right? So this Ferranti effect will be you will observe only in under no load or light load condition, and that is also for long transmission lines. Okay, in medium you don't remember in medium also, right? If the medium length is very near to the long line length, so then you can observe Ferranti effect. Okay, so this Ferranti effect is mainly due to the capacitive current. That capacitive current you can also call it as charging current. The current flowing through the capacitance is called the charging current or capacitive current. Okay, that charging current or capacitive current will be more when there is a no load on the transmission line. Okay, so because of that reason, your VER value is greater than VS value. Okay, so now for analyzing this Ferranti effect, we were considering a rigorous three methods. So we were explaining the Ferranti effect based upon our rigorous solution, based on the approximate basis, and based on our nominal pi model. Okay, so if in your exams if they were asked about a Ferranti effect, you no need to write all three methods. You can write any one method for explaining the Ferranti effect. Okay, and you can reduce the Ferranti effect by connecting the shunt reactors. Okay, when you connect the shunt reactor, they will draw the lagging current, right? And capacitance will be drawing the leading current. So those two currents will be when these two currents are equal, so then they will neutralize and becomes equal to zero. So your receiving end voltage will be approximately equal to your sending end voltage. Okay, that means you are receiving end voltage you are going to reduce by connecting your shunt reactor. Okay, so this is about your Ferranti effect. So what is time now? Okay, right, ma, it is almost 12. So I'm stopping here. If you're having any doubts here, you can ask me. Okay, still you are having 4 minutes. If you're having any doubts, you ask me. We will discuss about this wavelength propagation of wave length and surge impedance and surge impedance loading. So these topics in the next class. Okay, I'm stopping here. If you're having any doubts, you can ask me. See here, ma. From this expression, your Ferranti effect depends upon your frequency, square of the frequency and length of the transmission line. Okay, so if you observe the approximation method, approximate analysis method also, you see here magnitude of rise. This value also depends upon the square of the length and omega. Omega here is the frequency, angular frequency. Okay. So this Ferranti effect depends upon the square of the length of the transmission line, square of the frequency, and square of inversely proportional to velocity, square of the velocity of propagation of the wave. Why in DC transmission voltage drop is not observed? Who said So in DC transmission also voltage drop will be considered. Okay, you can observe. So if there is a DC transmission, somebody asking why is DC voltage drop is not observed. Okay, so we will observe the transmission voltage drop in DC also. Okay, see here. If you take a DC transmission line, right? So DC transmission line will be having two wires, right? One positive wire and another is negative wire. So this these wires will be having some resistance now. So there may not be inductance effect, there may not be capacitance effect. So but there will be having some resistance for your conductors.